is Gianna Palazon, and I chose to do my food presentation on sweet potato gnocchi. So, what is gnocchi? Gnocchi are traditionally made from flour and potatoes, and they can either be boiled or baked, but first they are rolled and cut into small pieces, which are cooked to make these small, fluffy looking pillows. They do come from a part of Asia. Potatoes originally were first migrated and coming from Asian in the early Polynesians, who took it to South America and also to the homeland of here, and then as well as Hawaii and New Zealand. So the nutrition composition of sweet potatoes, they are mainly comprised of carbohydrates, which is why the sweet potato is considered a starch. And the vegetable is especially nutrient-rich in beta-carotene, vitamin C, and potassium. Because sweet potatoes are a whole plant food, it does contain many plant vitamins, which makes it a very healthy starch. And sweet potatoes are healthy for you because they have lower GI and they're better for your digestion in comparison to normal potatoes. Looking at the nutrition facts, for 100 grams of raw sweet potatoes, there's 86 calories. It's made up of 77% water. There's only 1.6 grams of protein. There's 20.1 grams of carbs, 4.2 grams of sugar, 3 grams of fiber, and 0.1 grams of fat. So relationship to disease. So sweet potatoes, they prevent vitamin A deficiency. They improve blood sugar regulation, and they also can reduce oxidative damage and cancer risk. So the sweet potato gnocchi that I made was from Trader Joe's. In the frozen section, it was the brown butter and sage sweet potato gnocchi, and the ingredients in that were sweet potatoes, wheat flour, potatoes, water, butter made from cream and milk, milk, eggs, sunflower seed oil, and grana padano cheese, sugar, salt, and sage. So the agriculture of sweet potatoes, the availability, because potatoes were such low price and also had very high nutrient properties, they were consumed in vast quantities and really available, and they're also year-round, but they're most popular during the fall and winter. Sweet potato production is very sustainable because it's obviously not made from any animals, so it is the plant which makes it a very sustainable food. Sweet potatoes, they're available year-round, but the plants are planted in May and they grow all summer. But September is probably the best month to buy them because that's when they're harvested. Okay, so the recipe for the Trader Joe's frozen meal, first you can add olive oil into a nonstick pan on the stove on medium heat, and then you can add, optional if you want, you can add zucchini to the pan and season that, and then cook the zucchini just until it's softer, whenever you want it. And then I added the bag of frozen gnocchi and also a cup of corn, and then I just stirred that and covered that until the gnocchi got soft, because you want to make sure that it's warm all the way through. And then you can add more seasoning like red pepper flakes and also arugula, and then I serve it with cheese. So my tasting experience, I was very happy when I tried the Trader Joe's sweet potato gnocchi. I've only ever had like normal gnocchi, and I was really surprised that the brown butter and sage sauce actually came out. I was like skeptical at first because I didn't understand how that would work. But once I cooked it, then the sauce like was warm and it was in the pot too, which was nice. And that definitely added more flavor just because the sweet potato flavor was very faint. And I would say that this type of gnocchi was more dense than normal gnocchi, but that also might have to do with the fact that it did come from the freezer section. But regardless, I thought it was really good and I would definitely buy it again. Here's a picture of the sweet potato gnocchi that I made from Trader Joe's. Then, so comparing my culture, so I'm actually an Italian citizen, so I've definitely had gnocchi lots and lots of times. It's a tradition in my family to make it every Christmas, but I've never had sweet potato gnocchi, and I only saw or heard about sweet potato gnocchi because I started shopping at Trader Joe's, and there's a lot of hype around their frozen section, the gnocchi there. Gnocchi, it's not really a super popular dish in the United States, but I have seen it before at traditional Italian restaurants. Not really like Italian American restaurants, just more like the traditional type. And not a lot of people are exposed to this famous Italian staple dish unless you are like a food connoisseur or go to a lot of Italian restaurants. But potatoes in general, they were very common for people back then, which is why it was very convenient to make gnocchi with these simple ingredients. And then here are my references. And that's it. Thank you.